Our life is full of needs, full of requirements. We have to think a lot to fulfill our wish and will. This life is not for sport. It is not for fun. There is a lot more seriousness we have to harbor in our mind before we set out on our life journey. So this life journey is nothing but a serious pondering, thinking and reflecting, reciting and rehearsing. If you recite your past, then I understand there are so many pitfalls and from which I never knew how I overcame all those things. I do not know, but I only understand that I have fallen to a depth of my misery. I have fallen ill, I have lost my income, and I do not know what to do about my provisions for tomorrow. So the provisions are first to the mind, and then it happens before you. Without anything coming to my mind, even the nearest provision, the need, when it is so close to me, I will not go after it if the mind doesn't command me. When the mind is active, I have to understand what my mind is talking to me about. So feel free and remove yourself from all the obstacles of your knowledge. We know nothing about our future. All that we know is about our past. But we are living for the future. We are living only for the future, but what we have at hand is about the past. So my knowledge is about the past. This one we must understand. The knowledge will take me back to my old days and old ways. And everybody is possessing the knowledge, so they are driven back, their faces to their backs. And their journey is backwards, and never they can look forward to any good thing. If you look back, you will understand your knowledge takes you to the losses and the evil. You gain more and more of the evil than gaining as a recompense to your best deeds. So what do we have at hand now about tomorrow? The same life. I have fear and I have some sort of worriment in me. I do not know where I am leading, whether I am progressing or I am digressing, whether I am prosperous or I am going to lose even the minimal things I possess today. What am I to gain today is the knowledge, the better knowledge. That means not of the past knowledge. I want a better life with better knowledge. So where will you go for the better knowledge? When the people know certain things, it is already the knowledge that has come to the fore. We don't want this knowledge. We want the knowledge that the human being does not possess. Why do we need such knowledge? That nowhere else you can find this knowledge. Because I want a competition-free life. I don't want to be leading a worrisome life as everybody is leading. Without knowing what will happen to me tomorrow, I don't want to do anything. I don't want to gamble in my life. Others may say it is an effort from you. It is you are trying your best to achieve the best. No, trying means I am hoping to do something about which I do not know. It is only an experiment I am making in my life. I don't want to waste my life on experiments. You do not know whether the outcome of my experiment is going to be good for you or it is going to be not productive to you. So when you begin to think everything as if it has come to you. think everything that should come to you. At least think in the way that your life will be progressive towards the goal that you have in your mind. If you appreciate your mind, you will say that definitely the mind is not a thing to be perceived by palpation. It doesn't have a shape or size to see. It is invisible. And so it is going beyond the appreciable qualities of all our five senses. The physical senses cannot appreciate the mind. Mind can be appreciated by the insight. I have a mind. I sense by the insight and I feel there is a mind. So mindfully I have to live that I go by my instincts and inspiration and the intuition. Not from the knowledge and institution I will live. It is absolutely waste. You don't want fear in your life. The fear is about tomorrow. You don't want to worry. Worry about my inability to handle anything that I see here, that I come to face. I am not able to deliver myself out of this entanglement, out of this difficult position. Knowledge has come to a dead end. I have to progress further. This is your mind. Your mind says, when all doors are closed for you and you are in a terrible situation, I want to come out of it. This is the beginning of your new life. Every mind level intuition and inspiration is, you must have a better life. Today my mind says, I don't want my present position. Your present position is based on your knowledge, not what you possess. But normally we go by our bank balance and our properties or wealth. We don't even bother about our health. The wealth and possessions, how much I have, is what is going to guarantee me about my future. Definitely it is not. Your knowledge is limited, your knowledge is producing, your knowledge is grabbing, your knowledge is gathering the wealth that is available to your senses. What is sensible within you is the principle, the unseen principle. Your heart requires certain things. The important thing is, you don't want fear, you don't want to worry about the future. You don't want the past grief to follow you. Mind's peace and perseverance and patience is most important to achieve your goal. What you possess is the knowledge, what you shall possess is the knowledge, and what you will ever aspire for is only the knowledge, nothing but it. The knowledge makes the money, makes the provisions to come to you. If you go after the money and provisions, then your knowledge is substantive. You will be competitive and others will compete you. Each one's account should be borne by other people because they are competitors. One's burden will be laden on another and his burden will be loaded onto the back of another person. This is the life that we are leading now. You want knowledge or you want the properties and wealth? You want a greater knowledge or you want a knowledge that is available today? What we are studying in colleges and institutions is the knowledge as of existing now. So we don't want this knowledge if we want to be free from the fear and worry. So, chapter 2, 62, verse number 62 says, the last line says, they will not have fear, they will not be griefsome. The past deeds will not follow them. Presently, there is no worry for them, and about tomorrow, the fear will not touch them. This is the heavenly life in this world. You want this life or you want any other life other than this? Whatever be the amount of wealth that you may have, properties you may have, the money you may have, will not give you the peace and beautiful prosperity or the peace inside of me about all the three tenses of my life, the past and the present and the future. In these situations, I will follow only my heart. The heart says, follow your heavenly life here. That means fear-free and worry-free life. Who can give you this? Which knowledge can give you this? I don't want money, I want peace. So we want the way to peace. We want a way towards solution of all my problems. We want a way, the way in which my sins will be forgiven and His grace will be given to me in as much blessing, in as much need as I want, as I may require. So which part of life will give me this sort of peaceful life presently and ahead of me? There is nothing except God's provision to you that you will have a life of existence free from worry and fear. So this verse and the sentence teaches us how to be free from worry and fear, free from grief and worry. So the verse begins, those of you who believe. Belief is what you have in your mind, or belief is what you know of the knowledge. I have something in my mind. I know some knowledge which doesn't cater to my requirement, my mental requirement, my requirement of heart. I want peace at any cost. If I don't have money, my peace is disturbed. So the peace must bring money. Money should be peaceful when I am going to gain it. My earning must be peaceful. It should not be the hard way. If it is the hard way, the result will be the hardest way. If I am cheating, I will be cheated. If I am denouncing that only money is important, not heart, then definitely heart will be on the one side, your prosperity will be on the other side. Both will not come close to each other without a helping hand from each other. Things will be aloof. I am suffering in my mind, but I am wealthy with my provisions. I am not at all happy with the position of my mind, with the status of my mind, because it is worried. So much of health is there. My physical health is there. My physical wealth is there. This physical being and the properties and wealth that is surrounding me is not going to help my heart towards its peace. What will happen? I want to die. As the richest man in the world, I want to die. And we have seen people die with enough riches with them. So this is the life we want? No. But give peace to the heart. All the wealth will come to you in a peaceful manner, and you don't have to go after the wealth. God has created you in the best possible manner as a beautiful creation of all the creations from heaven to earth. Much above in degrees, God has given a grace to the mind of a human being. And He has graced a human being with a mind. No other animal has the mind. No other creation has the mind. Except that by intuition they follow the command of God. But here we are given a choice to beat the entire world so that you will be the representative of God on this earth. This earth will be your office to rule the heavens and the earth together. Nothing can be against you. What you require is food. So believe that you must have food for your life, for your entire life. But how you are taught, you need money for your entire life. Money and food are the same. When it is not the same, how can you go after the money without bothering the life of you, without bothering the health He has given to you? and the health is gained by rest, not by overtiring, not by hard working. You will become weary, you will become weak, you will become tired, and you will become tiresome. Is this going to give you a life to the heart? No. You want peace means you must take enough rest, but we are working day and night. What for night has come, what for day is given to you. Night is given to you for your rest, for peace of mind. Unless the mind is set at peace, there is no question of having a good sleep. If you don't have a good sleep, this is not a starting point for you the next day when you wake up. Before the dawn breaks, you must break away from all the worries and grief of the yesterdays. We follow the command of Allah. Allah means the none but Him. We worship Him as the none but Him. We surrender to Him, submit Him totally. When you say Allah, the none but Him, that's the stage you must arrive before turning to God. If you have more of your own knowledge, abilities, then God says, go finish off all your knowledge and abilities and come to me humbly. Humbling yourself, stay before me, and I am the only one to succor you. I am the only one to help you. I am the only one who created you and who will nurture you and care for you. Will you come to me empty-handed, or you will come to me with so much of your knowledge behind you, backing you? In that way, you come to me as if nothing is going to happen to you, even if I don't help you. So you have so many options within you, even as you come to me begging. So get rid of all your options now and submit to me as if you have nothing. Will you then spend from your wealth if you are true to your words? I have nothing. I seek your grace. Unless you provide me, I have everything here to lose. Nothing will stay with me. Nothing will guard me against your design. So will you come to me in this manner or not? Will you be a believer now, not in yourself but in God? Or something other than you? That something is not ordinary but extraordinary. You believe in that extraordinary power, you believe in that extraordinary knowledge, the wisdom. And the wisdom is with God, and God is above all of you, all of the creations. Then will you value me, regard me as such, and come to me empty-handed, submitting yourself to me, leaving behind all your knowledge? But the knowledge is in the foreground. After coming to me, after praying to me, you go back, turning on your heels. Show me your backs, and then go to your work. When you go to your work, God says, He doesn't say don't go to your work. Don't go to your work with the same evil qualities, with the same deception, with the same cheating attitude, with the same treacherous attitude. Be righteous in dealing with your people, in dealing with your business, and fear me. I am seeing you. I am going to guide you in that. When you speak good things, because you believe when I do good things in the righteousness, in the best possible qualities I have, the godly qualities, then you have the godliness in you that has the power to guide you and to lead you towards the prosperous and the best future, growing ever by the time. You will not fall ill, you will not lose anything of your wealth and properties, and everything will have the life in it. What you gain, what you reap by the evil qualities by which you come before the people for your trade and bargaining, the amount of wealth that you amass, it is not going to help you. It is lifeless. It will take your life away from you, so that your heart will be not resting in peace. While you are living, or even after your death, your heart will not rest in peace. The heart belongs to Him, and He controls the heart. how he controls the heart. If you are a believer, believe that he has the power over your heart. He controls your heart. He guides your heart. When I am doing a wrong thing, he says it is wrong. That pure distinction and discernment that I have in my mind, when I do a wrong thing, when I do a wrong, and when I have a wrong understanding, and when I have something against my own people, and I hide, conceal within, and dissemble come, I come out dissembling. I come out feigning. With a false appearance that I am a good person. To make you believe that they can believe me, even I was, as I was hiding deep within me, that I know I am a wrong person, I am not showing it out. But my heart says, you are a wrong person. It guides me. Don't take to these paths. Fear God and guard yourself against the future. What you are going to do today, you are going to reap tomorrow. You believe. So we are believers. Not that because he believes in Allah, the word Allah, the sound Allah, Jesus, or any other God they name. It is only a plain but not true. A plain word, it doesn't have any truth inside. What is true, you speak out. What is not true, don't speak. Don't harbor it in your mind if you are a believer. I am a believer of tomorrow. I am a believer in what I don't possess today, but that which I want to possess tomorrow, but that which I want to possess all the time. Yes or no? I am a believer in that my life will be better tomorrow. Unless you have a better way, there's no better life tomorrow. You want the human way, or you want the godly way? Human way is possessing all the evil qualities, the satanic qualities within me. I want to live at the cost of humanity. This is your life. Whatever be your profession, whatever be your trade, when you go for money, your main faith, your main belief is about your own knowledge, being grateful to your own understanding and giving regard to your own way of life. And you will see all the others lower than you. You look down upon them. Change this quality. What I don't possess, others may be possessing. Unless I am humble, I have no insight to imbibe the good qualities of others. I have no discerning ability to see the evil and the best qualities in a person and to use the best qualities living around the evil so that you guard against their evil capacities. My ability is to discern, to distinguish between the good and evil. What is better for me, what is worse for me? What is better for them, what is worse for them? What is worse for them, I will not follow. What is better for both? When we come against each other, we will be shaking hands heartwise. We are shaking hands heartily. We will not be against their wish, and I will not go against my own order. When my mind says you are doing a wrong thing, you are going the wrong way, I adjust myself, I guard myself towards the best qualities. And I speak the best words so that I remove their evil qualities against me and I use the best of their lot. So we come face to face as a better partnership that is going to happen all your life. You will not harm another person and they will not harm you. Then mostly my fear and worry are gone. As long as I have my fear and worry, it is the reward that you have saved for your future because of your evil ways, because of your wrong commitments, because you think that unless I earn, there is no way I can lead a life tomorrow. in what way you must learn is the only way that is going to give you life tomorrow. Having the godliness inside you, having the godly qualities inside you is most important. So God says, if you are a believer in godliness, the quality will survive you. The wrongdoings and the satanic instincts will cause death to you even as you are living. There's no point in living if you have the satanic qualities in you. There are only two qualities that gives you life or that takes your life out of you. Godly qualities will give you the best part of your life, and the satanic qualities, when God says it is wrong, the mind says it is wrong, it means that God is guiding you towards the righteousness. When I don't know what else to do, keep quiet and put all your trust in me. I am going to help you with a better knowledge. So improve and increase your knowledge over the qualities of others. We have our own evil qualities, we know, and correct the qualities. How will you correct the qualities? You will not do what your mind forces you to do. I have to speed up my work only to blind your eyes so that my speed and my abilities will make you foresee things that are going to be much better for you, making you to overlook without discerning whether I am saying right or wrong. So I am foreseeing my future when I am not at all good in my heart, when I am having only the money before me in my heart, and the wealth that I am going to usurp away from the people alone is made in my heart. With these qualities, Shaitan has come to you. You don't worry about the grace of God. You don't want the grace of God, but you want the provisions of Shaitan, where there is no life in it. When you take a grain of rice, when you take vegetables, it is all poisoned. You poison it. Because of the poisoned mind, the poisons are invented as medicines, as your life's existence. And as your life sustenance, these medicines, these evil quality products that has the poison and venom inside, the venom of your mind has created the poisonous materials. So what your mind possesses is the reward that you are going to reap. You have sown your seed in your heart as the wrong things. And God says, no, don't harbor these wrong things in your heart. Clean your mind. Clean up your mind. Take the best qualities of me. I am the creator. So will you believe in the creator or will you believe in the inventor? Invention is your life. Creation is life. Life and life cannot go together. Death and wrongdoings have already joined hands. Godliness and God himself, the creation, the creator, everything has joined hands. All afresh. You will be created all anew. Which part of life you want? I want your life always sustaining by itself. It can take care of itself without my abilities. All your abilities will be concentrating on developing your attitude in the godliness, developing your understanding from the Creator, and progressing towards your future without fear and worry. If you don't have fear and worry, you are on the right track. If you have fear and worry, already you are on the wrong path. So that is the guidance that you have, that is the ordainment, the none but Him, Allah, gives you. Change your ways. If not, whatever you have now as worry and fear will be coming before you in form and shape, and the situation will be very disturbing to you in the coming days. You will be in the worst situation than what you are today, and before going to the worst level, change today. You are growing worse and worse. day by day. Until such time you attain the peace today, definitely know that you are going to suffer something or other that is not at all suitable for your life. You cannot think anything other than what you are suffering. The suffering must go first, then the life comes. I want to live. Very ordinarily, if you have a fever, you want the fever to go first. You will not think about your life tomorrow. You have a disease, the disease must go first. That has a priority. So the evil must go, and you don't know how to get rid of any disease that you are suffering. The whole humanity is suffering. The modern medicine cannot cure any disease. It can only camouflage a disease. It can only suppress a disease. They see only the symptom. They cannot understand what makes the symptom to develop. They see only the disease through MRI scans. They don't understand how a pathology is created here. Even is also created, that must have an energy. Your health is also created, that must have an energy. Anything bad or good, you must have the energy to activate it, to conduct it, and to guide it towards your goal. If an evil is turned to me, if a force that is not good for me, that is affecting harm to me, if it is directed towards me, the direction and timing and haunting me, hunting me, there must be an energy. Without energy, evil also cannot raise its head. So the more and more you have that evil qualities, that is having an energy that will create and draw the evil to come to you. You will taste your own misuse. So I am not creating an evil, but it is created. Believe in the unseen. So you will be creating the good thing that should come to you in the same unseen way. In the way a disease comes to me, in the way a fever attacks me, in the way all harmful effects pounce upon me when I am not creating, when I am not going and getting. It is created from your heart. So believe the unseen power in the heart of a human being will create the same thing that wish that they possess in the heart. Good for good and bad for bad. But you think all the good things should be worked out by you. You must go and gather everything, then only you can have your provisions. But how come a fever comes? How come a disease comes? How can a kidney failure can come to you? What is the reason? You don't know the reason, but how does it come to you? Even if you try your best, put your hardest effort to ward off all the diseases of the future, still it will come to you. When evil things can come to you without your wanting it, the good things will not come to you while you are wishing for it. So be a believer in the unseen force. You are given your hand and foot to ward off the evil, not to gain the good things. Don't do evil. That's for why your hands are given to you. If your heart is leaning, inclining towards me, then from there the good-hearted spirit will guide your limbs, will guide your exterior members. If you follow the knowledge, that is the most evil way that it will conduct, then you are going to use the same limbs against you. Whatever you do will cause more harm. I take medicines, it causes harm to me. Just to remove one symptom of my disease, I create tens of symptoms with my own hands. I am drawing the evil upon me. I am drawing the evil energy to embrace me, and I love my knowledge for that. I think that my knowledge is embracing me, my knowledge is protecting me, my knowledge is giving me comfort. On the other hand, it is a great discomfort and it is an affliction for you. Your distress is going to start till the end, where the painful torment cannot be tolerated anymore. I can end my own life. This is not the way we will be living. Be a believer. Every word of this scripture, Quran, is a guidance to you. See what it says. If you are a believer, does not matter. If you believe in God, okay. So, what is God? All good things are God. All good things are God. All good things are godly. All good things are godliness in you, provided by Him. Who created this good and evil? Who made you understand what is good and what is evil? How will you assess whether you are doing the wrong thing? How will you be satisfied that you have done the right thing? Who guides you? Who speaks to you? Deep within. God says whether you have seen the God. I say no, I have not seen the God. But how do you know there is a God? Yes, there is a God. But how do you know? Say you taught me. From where? From nowhere. But how close I am to you to teach you this? So close. So I am nowhere, but I am with you. Will you follow me now? I am with you. I am closer than your life. If I leave you, there is no life for you. You will not have the heart to believe in your future. Despite all your distresses and diseases and afflictions, definitely you want to live tomorrow. With what will you live? You have finished all your knowledge. You have come to a close now. You are in utter darkness. You do not know what to do. Now we want the light. The light of wisdom. The knowledge above everyone else. That knowledge comes to you. You are delivered. So from the deepest troubles, I think my life has ended. This situation has come to me a lot of times in my life. Earlier life. And these sort of situations have occurred to every single person. Who can recite it today? Who can rehearse it from this moment that I am going to lead a life full of honor? I am going to lead a life with full of dignity. I am going to lead a life by His grace. This is the need of me. This is the requirement of me. Will we follow my requirement of tomorrow, or will I follow the knowledge that has already come to an end? And that end has been shown to me a lot of times in my earlier life. Definitely it has been shown to me during my earlier days. But because of such and such diseases, I might have totally been discarded by the entire world. The world would have deserted me. That is the end. That is the point I had reached. Because there is no light for me. I am in total darkness. I do not know what else to do. I feel the entire world has deserted me. Not an atom of this earth is helping me. Then the help came. And I say, it is God's grace that I am surviving today. Even when we are raising up our children, there are so many instances when I might have considered him to be dead. But he comes back. After your death, he has given you life. It is not that he is physically dead and he has been made alive, but your heart will say, it is a new life for me. I never thought my son or my daughter would have come out of this disease, but definitely God's grace came upon us and we are surviving as a family now. Still I have my children with me. So God gives you a clear evidence to you that He is with you, and you are a close witness to His evidence that but for Him, none will be survived in this moment. Umpteen number of times God has shown you His kindness, He has given you His forgiveness, and His mercy is what we are now experiencing through all our lives. But we were forgetful and we were not grateful to what God has delivered to us. He has been with us since the time He has given me the life. He has infused life ever since He is with me. for life will be with me. This is how I see God in the unseen form. I am reciting my past to the present, and I will be rehearsing from this moment this recitation and understanding and discernment that if God is not there, I am nowhere. Where is God? He is so close to me. So be a believer. Don't believe in what you have invented as God. Believe who is with you, guiding you, giving you life. Even as you are destroying yourself, ruining yourself, He is giving you the guidance, He is giving you a new life. Every breathing is a new life. And in the breathing is His message. Do not worry. Do not fear. This is the message. Do not worry. Do not fear. Don't worry about your past. You might have done so many things. And you might remember now that I have done such a grave mistake. It may be a sin before the eyes of God. But I have done it. But now who says, do not worry? Who can say this? Only God says. And think about your future. You want a better life. Who can say this? If He has not forgiven you, how can these words come to your heart now? So never have doubt when you have something for your tomorrow as a better life for you, which you have to hope for and aim for, and which you will submit to your own God, whoever is speaking to you. He is God. God is speaking to you. God is speaking to us. God is speaking to every soul. So follow your God, follow your God, follow your God, follow each one's God. And we follow our God. He is the one. You don't believe me, I don't believe you. We don't believe each other. We don't make us as gods. We don't make some of us as gods for others. And nobody has the authority as far as human beings concerned, one upon the other. Except God has authority over everyone. So be a slave to God. Be submissive. Be humble before people. God will guide you and He will raise you above in degrees. He will raise you to the heights above everyone. And everyone will be raised to their own heights. Nobody can reach that height. Sun is placed in a position. Moon is placed in a position. Star is placed in orbit. Both have different heights. One cannot compete with the other. One cannot rule over the other. If the star must appear, it must appear only in the night, however greatly it is lifted. Whatever be the height it is placed, however big it is, it has to appear only in the night, it cannot come in the daytime. We are speaking philosophically, we are not speaking literally. Literally means whatever is visible, we are understanding, and we follow that little understanding as knowledge, that's not sufficient, heart is invisible. So philosophically, you raise yourself from a little standard to understand things. And thereafter, your mind will guide you towards the unseen future. The future is there, but I do not know how your future will be, but it is there. Some 10 years back, I do not know how we would be, but here it is the future. Considering 10 years back, I am taking myself 10 years back, and I can see the future of 10 years later, that is this day. Can you see? But today I am seeing a future is there. I have not seen it 10 years back. I had some worries about me, about my life. What will happen to me after 10 years? 10 years are over now. We are not at all affected in any way. Who saved your life to this day, from your past to today? But still we have the fear, still we have the worry about tomorrow. The same thing is going to happen. He is going to deliver you when the tomorrow comes. You don't have to worry. If you are grateful enough, think about your past and you will definitely know you have not guided yourself to the present situation, and thereafter, from this moment, the one who has guided you all these years is going to guide you. Have minimal gratitude towards your God. Definitely He is most appreciative of the gratefulness you show to Him. Show your thanks to Him. And be thankful to Him because I am surviving today. And regard Him as the superior, most protective force, guiding force, and he is your provider, nourisher, caretaker. He is nurturing you, appreciating the basic, minimal, cardinal principles that you have. God is there. He will protect you. This is shown when you are at the height of your distress. So that minimal appreciation is sufficient to consider you as the greatest person. That much is his mercy on you. He is relenting. He is patient. Otherwise, you will be done away without any problems to him long time ago. But he doesn't. He is so much loving and kind towards the human beings. But we are showing our animosity, showing our anger, showing our intemperate nature against each other. We were absolutely disobedient, rebellious against all God's mercy He has given to us. So believe in the unseen future while understanding that your fear and your worry should not be there if you believe me. That's what you want. Before even you believe, you have already received that you don't want to suffer any distress in the future. You don't want to suffer any disabilities in the future. God is definitely seeing you, intently watching you, whatever you do. After having received His mercy, that there need not be a future that is going to give you an affliction, a distress, a painful torment, a doom shall not happen on you. This is what is God is speaking to you, and you already received and you wanted it. Thereafter you begin to oppose it because your knowledge, you think that it is superior to God's endowment. You think your knowledge is much greater than God's word and promise. So after receiving it, you go against it. God is not giving you any problems. He is not doing you any harm, but we are just causing harm to us. Then we blame it on God. What you possess in the heart is going to happen. What you believe in the heart is going to happen. So believers, do believe only in the rightest manner. Do believe only the rightest manner is going to give you the rewards for all your life. Will you believe now in your heart of hearts, whatever is given to you is the truth, and whatever you are opposing is based on the untruth, your falsehood. Don't believe in the falsehood. Don't believe in your knowledge. Knowledge, what we possess, is about our past. Wisdom is for your future. Believe in the wisdom. The wisdom is going to conduct you. You won't know that wisdom is conducting you. When I am speaking something good and earning something out of that, that is wisdom. When I am speaking the falsehood, when I am having to, this is the only way that I have in my mind that I have to deceive you, I have to cheat you, I have to be treacherous, I can't be plain and open, I cannot be living. I have to be in the wrong way. If this is what I believe, then feel that at least now you are going to reap whatever you have gained. It is not to your gain, but it is to your dismay, going to give you everything that is unbearable for you. Your life will be gloomy, and it has been already given to you. Whatever be the amount you are earning today, the money you are amassing today, still the worry is there whether it will last. Definitely it will not last. That's the meaning of it. But I am earning only a little today. I have no worries about tomorrow. This is the grace of God. Definitely there is no worry for you. There is no shortage for your provisions. Tomorrow, rather it will increase. Slowly and steadily, or he may give you abundantly. It is all based on the righteousness that you have in the heart that will not waver afterwards when you are given a comfortable life. You will not become yourself a God now by forgetting God. When I am forgetting God, I am God myself. That's it. Don't make two gods. One, when I am seriously suffering, I am going to real God. Once the suffering is relieved, I become my own God. I am forgetting. We are living as people who have two gods. At the time of suffering, the real God will be coming to my mind. Once the suffering is removed, I become my own God. I know what to do. Today, fear Him. The apparent fear that you have will be removed. You will have comfortable life here, all the time in fearing Him. If you follow your knowledge, you will be fearing about the loss of your comforts and provisions, and penury will be your final end, and thereafter you will be suffering ill health also, and from that suffering also, you will not find a way out of your diseases that has come your way, afflicted you very deeply, causing agonizing pain to you. You will have then no belief if you become your own God. I have my hands and feet. I have my mouth. Why God has given to me? You speak all the wrong things. You speak all the evil things. And you do in the way that your heart is commanding you. Only start enjoying the world's amusement and pleasures physically, even if it is wrongful to the mind. Yes, I want my physical enjoyment. That means you have downgraded yourself from the highest level, not obeying the command of your heart. That command has come from God because it is godly. This world's enjoyment is very meek. This world's enjoyment is only for a short while. It is meanest of all things. When it gives comfort to your heart, that is best for you. When it comes from, gives comfort to your physical being, then it is like you are leading your life up here. An animal, the five sensed animal, you have not used the special sense, the insight. Use your insight, you will be beating out these five special senses, and your heart will provide you all that you wanted. He is going to create it for you, very near to you. Within your hand's reach, He is going to create it. He will create for you everything that you require as requirement given by you, not that which you require as your desires speak to you. Desires induce you. Don't get seduced by the desires of the worldly pleasures. Follow the heart. God is going to create you, everything and you. All the heavenly things will come to you when He is creating you specifically for you. All the hellish things will be created here if you follow, and the wrong attitude that you have is not amended. Mend it. Amend yourself towards a greater glory. You are going to create by your own hands the evil in food, the evil in your earning. That evil is going to haunt you forever. Once the mind is haunted, then from there the diseases develop. The attitudes change to the worst, and you will be discarded by the public openly. You will have nowhere to go. You cannot face the people. And they are not going to have any compassion for you, any mercy for you, except that they will be punishing you without heart. This is happening all around us here today. So come to chapter 2, verse number 62, whether you are a believer, whether you are a Jew, whether you are a Christian, whether you belong to any other religion on earth which you had invented. The Muslims say, I am a believer. The Christians say, I am a believer. Like Jews say, I am a believer. Yeah, likewise, every people following the religion, they say they are a believer. In who? God. But they don't follow godliness. So whether you are a Muslim, Christian, Jew, or Safi, any other group of people following any other religion, if you don't follow the godliness, then you are not a believer. As long as I am using my knowledge, I know that I am following only the earthly things. I am only following the evil inspired by Shaitan in my heart. I am not following God. When I have no knowledge, now you are surviving, it is because of godliness. You do not know, but you are living. So the wisdom you will not be able to understand, but you can perceive, you can comprehend. You can discern, you can appreciate things above me. A power above me is guiding me. And he alone possesses that knowledge. I am guided by him. I am worried. In between, I am relieved of the worry. And again, I am thinking of my tomorrow. I am worried. He removes the thinking of tomorrow because tomorrow is in his hands. When you think tomorrow is in your hands, then the God asks you, tomorrow is in your hands or tomorrow is in my hand? All the believers, Muslim, Christian, Jews, ask them, with whom is the tomorrow? With whom is your life? With him. Then what are you thinking about tomorrow? You have given me the knowledge. You have created the medicines. And the doctors have learned the medicines. Then we take it that you guide us towards the doctors. It is you who made the medicines, so I go after them. Then why are you suffering more and more? Every time you go to the doctors and take medicines, why the sufferings are increasing? Why they are not able to cure? If I have given the medicines, should it cure you or not? God is asking you. What is the answer? When I have guided you towards the doctors, have I guided you falsely that you go and meet death there? And intensive care, all the specialists have accumulated together there. You still die. Have I directed you wrongly, knowingly? Am I treacherous? Is that my quality? God is asking you. What's your answer now? No, you are not treacherous. You are true. You are not guiding me wrongly. You are righteous. I am not treacherous, but I am righteous. I am doing only good to you. But you go and earn all your evil over there. Your misdeeds brings you all your miseries. Then you say that I have guided you to the doctor. How sure you are? Now answer. God is guiding you, or you have taken God besides God in doctors? So they prove to be false. They cannot say, I will cure you. When you go to God, he will say, I will cure you or not. Yes. And he has already given you the word, you should be cured. Taking that, you go to him again, cure me, with enough disbelief. So that God says, go away and come with belief. And we go to doctors. What the doctors say? Let us try. Try means, let's gamble. I will put in my best efforts, the doctors will say. They are putting in their best intelligence to gamble it with your life. Trial means gambling. I do not know the result this way or that way. It's a luck, a game of chance. We will never resort to that. God has not created you medicine. God has created for you food. But you take medicine and fear the food. If you have the righteousness inside of you, some good sense inside of you, you will take in food and fear the medicines. How you are taken the exactly wrong way. And thereafter hoping for a cure, and thereafter coming to me that I must help you in your way. What will happen? Exactly on the opposite direction to my to my way. And you go there, go to doctors, you don't leave the doctors and turn to me. You go to the doctors and you want me to help in your way, what will happen? You go down the train very fast if I help you in your direction. Most of our prayers are asking the God to help me in my evil way. God says, stop it and turn my way. I show my back to him and turn to the ways of the people and then calling him to help me in his direction. This is your prayer. God should listen to your prayer if he wants to help you, or God should not listen to your prayer. If he listens to your way, to your plea, and then he gives you his help in the direction that you face, what will happen to you, you must think. So be careful when you turn to God exactly the opposite way you are turning, you are asking him to help you. Definitely God is compassionate. God is having mercy on you. He will not help you. Then you will say, God is not helping me. I am going to the doctor, God must help me. Definitely he doesn't. Except when you are a cursed person by God, he will not leave you in your way. And you will have to get rid of the doctors and turn to God. But most people, they go and they sustain enough troubles, they get enough afflictions, they undergo enough torment, and finally they die in their hands. Finally, when they die, they blame God. These are the people who are cursed. Woe to them. Their life here has ended so miserably, and their life in the future will also be a miserable one. They stood as an evil witness before the people that this is the only way we have to die. Go to the doctors and meet your death. It is homicidal tendency on the part of the doctors. It is a suicidal tendency on the part of the patient. So both join hands together. And I give in writing, if I die, you are not responsible, God is responsible. So if I die in my own way, in the godly way, you will say that I have killed myself. You are punishable. Unless you go to the doctors, if you meet the death, you are punishable. If you go to the doctors and you die there, God is punishable. Doctors did all their work, but God did not turn to them. God did not return to them when they are far away from God. These are the cursed people and the cursed nation in which we are living, and the cursed world will be our descendants will be living. So we turn to God today. We remember them in the evil witnesses, those people who stood against godliness and lost their lives. They were the evil witnesses for the people to come. And they are a very bad example story. Who are going to doctors? So you believe in God, or you believe in the people other than the God? I am believing in the people. We make ourselves gods. We have got two gods. One is when we are in need, dire requirement, dire need, we believe that God. When we are relieved of it, I am believing myself, I am becoming my own God. There are two gods, only two gods. One I am, the God, first God, the second God. When I am deeply troubled, the role changes. He is the prime God, I become the second God. When you are given the relief, I become the only God and I forget him. This is the belief of all the people. They go to churches, temples and mosques. Nothing will do for them. Nothing is going to benefit for them. The moment I come out of my soul, come out of my treasure chest, gone away from me. This is not the life I will follow again anymore by seeing the people around. I will not go to mosques, churches, temples, any human built constructions, but I will stay here, the construction of God, that is my chest. In the soul, in my mind. My mind will be soulfully his. My mind will not be brainy. The worldly knowledge. I have no link, connection with the worldly knowledge. All your inventions are deadly. It is only from the God-created earthy materials. You have gathered here and there certain pieces and you are inventing. By wrong mixture, with wrong proportions, with wrong proposition inside, I want to create anything. Tell me what you have created with life. Even a mosquito can you create with life to it? Can you give life to it? Do you know what life is? How can you say it's a creation? Inventing a falsehood. Mimicking the creation of God. Mimicry is evil. Mimicry is bad. Mimicry is like joking and mocking at God's creations. He creates everything with life. You are creating without life and say, these are the inventions of our modern science. It can kill you, it cannot give you life. This phone can spoil my brain, attack my brain, attack my ear, attack my eyes. God created light. The reflection of light you can see. If you created light, definitely it is from inside attacking me directly. You cannot create that which you can see from the reflection. Reflection is good, direct vision is causing you blindness. You cannot sight the sun. God says, don't see me. See what I am showing you on the earth. So we are seeing here, we don't want to see the sun. But here, my knowledge is, see directly the sun that I created for you. Eyes are spoiled. The whole senses, five senses are spoiled. Because the heat, because the radiation, because the direct light, and I have not got any cue from the sunlight, I am seeing only the reflection, not the sun. Here also, if I am to invent, I have to create something that can be visible from the shade because of the reflection to it. The light is thrown on it, I am seeing the reflection from it. Then I must see, not the direct light. So my eyes will be blinded. Your creation, I am giving you an example, your creation of deadly, everything is created from the fire. God creates everything from the water. From the coolness He creates, the life is with the freshness and coolness, and the water element content is important for its life. But here, only the fire is giving you their inventions. And one drop of water is sufficient to put off. But their arrogance is overwhelming. I am the creator, they say, when they cannot create a thing. So there are two gods. One is the life creator, life sustainer, another is life destroyer and death word. You, a destroyer, he, the creator, you can't commit the both, me and him. Either he or you. Either you submit to him or be deserted away from him for a while. Until such time, you gather almost all the pleasures, finally you will be seized with a doom from where you will not be able to come out of it. You can't hire the doctors. They will take you to the fire. The more I am obedient, the more I am rebellious to myself. When it guides me, don't do this, I won't do it. Don't think about the future, I won't think about the future. But you will say, think about the future. Think about the future then, be worried. He says, don't think about the future, don't be worried. I created you, I will take you there. And you all know God is supreme. He is powerful over everything. He has that omnipotency to care for you all. From the time of the world is born to the end of the world. From the time you are born to your end, to your death. I am with you, the world, I will take care of you. But you say, it is enough, I will take care of me. Now fear God. Whether you are a believer, say you are a Muslim or a Mu'min, it does not matter to me at all. Tomorrow's life is with whose hands? With Him. Your future is with Him, your life is with Him, your entire provisions are with Him. He gives you. In just proportions and in just manner, in the way your heart functions. to bring the life force in the grains and vegetables and fruits, or to give you the venom in it, the toxins in it. The poisons you are going to grow, or you allow me to grow food for you. Now we know we have grown poisons, and we know that peasants are creating food for us, and God is creating for you. That's what we are thinking right now. The peasants are giving us the food, not God. So you taste the toxins of it, you take the poisons of it, and suffer diseases. Now I am believing God is the only grower for me. God is the only provider for me. I fear God and take the food. The poison is removed and the food is given a new life. It is not the peasants who are providing me, who are growing the food for me. It is only the God who can provide me the food part of the grains that have been grown by the peasants. If we think that the peasants have given us, then I am a patient. If you think God has given you the food, then definitely He is the provider for your life. So be grateful to God. Don't say that I am a believer in Allah, believer in Jesus, and believe in something else. Believing in the godliness, don't believe in God. Don't believe Him in the form and shape, believe Him in quality and character. And He is guiding you, conducting you. Don't allow yourself to be gone astray from Him, and be blessed by Him. And we have to come out of the curse that I incurred upon me, because I did not give a thought about my own life. I did not give a thought about my unseen abilities. I did not give a thought about the qualities that is going to conduct me towards my future. God has definitely forgiven us today and shown us the mercy. So again, if you are believing in God in the last day, there is so much in you as shortcomings, as you were feel to get a better life, to live a standard life, that is, without any wavering, without any ups and downs, a standard life, a progressive life if you want, that is the destination. A progressive life is my destination, not my wealthy life, not my healthy life. A progressive life is your destination. Unending, infinite definition you must have today. I must be progressive by the moment. That progression is for your mind, not for your physical body. The mind is conducting the physical body. And the mind is creating by this order whatever you require for as your provisions for your life, for the life of your mind. That from the mind, the body gains the health. The mind is affected, the body is affected. The mind is pristine, pure in quality, the body will be functioning in its fullest stability. So believe in godliness, don't believe in God. That godliness will be in your heart of hearts qualities, the human quality. And not inside the mosques, churches and temples. God is not there, God is here. God in form and shape is there. God in quality is here. Which one you want? You want the godly qualities, or you want the God in form and shape? You want the God's promise as His word, or you want God in form and shape? If you want God in form and shape, your life is null and void today. If you believe Him as a quality that you have to imbibe the quality, you have to be taking in His quality, then God is with you. Live by the qualities of God. That has the omnipotence. Not God. You have not seen God, but you know God in us pretty well. And you know that godliness cannot be seen. So which one you want to have in your heart? The godliness of God. God you have to invent, you cannot see. Godliness you can feel, and you can affirm and reaffirm that godliness is a quality definitely one should possess. And if though it is not to be seen, it can be appreciated by anyone when somebody is of good quality. Because God provides them a lot. So keep up the good qualities in you. Believe in what God says. Don't worry about tomorrow, that's my life. So His word will be true. this will be done. If only I don't value myself in association with God, that God and me are equal. God is a part of me, I am a part of God, I and God must work together, then only God will help you. Without my help, God is helpless. You also should work. You work in the wrong way. So, tie up your hands, hold your hands before me, and stay humble and quiet and keep the godly qualities. Now I will conduct your hands and feet. Now I will deliver your words. That will be soothing to the people. That will be comforting to you, comforting to the society. God will create more for you. Provisions will be given to you in plentiful. And that is the real provision. That is the real adornment for you. Not your provisions, not what you grow. This is the life God has allowed for you and nothing else. So if you believe and in the godliness, and if you think that godliness will be your endless and progressive future, then definitely for them is the reward, a goodly reward from God. And for them is no fear, no grief. This is chapter 2, verse number 62. Follow it. Abide by it. And we pray to God that whatever I had understood today, make it a reality for us, make it our nature, and nurture the nature so that it is strengthened. All the while, me and my descendants are living, and don't discard me. Don't leave me alone in my bewilderment. Allow me not to go my own way and get destroyed. And my life should not be in ruin. I have entrusted myself with you and my family with you and my children with you and my society with you. You are the best of the keepers, best of the watchers. And you will not fail us. Your promise is true. No one is truthful to his promise except you. You are my God. Now finally we are ending up in God. Follow it up with godliness and start with godliness. You know who God is. Don't imagine a God. He will lose out on all godliness. So let our life be started with the godliness, and we believe in God in the last day, progressive nourishment, progressive development, endless life to the heart, not to the body. Bodily features are only to know that godliness is true physically with all the five witnesses, five senses. I understand, yes, God's power is true, my own knowledge is untrue. God's power heals me, my own five senses power heals me. All the punishment that I receive upon myself, it is a curse upon me if I don't believe in the heart and believe in the five senses. I become an animal. I am to live as a human being, not as an animal. That is the worst life I can lead on this earth. Most of us are living that life. Today the life will change. There should definitely be a change in your attitude in your life from this moment. You are not God. Our knowledge is full of Saturday. Tomorrow is full of lesser life. But you use your knowledge for the future also, progressively deteriorating. And the deterioration has come to you today because you are worried, because you are fearing. If I have no worry and fear tomorrow, about tomorrow, I am the God living. If I worry, it's a direction to you that you must, caution to you, your warning to you that you are following the wrong path. You are following your knowledge. That means wrong path means your knowledge. Your ideas are wrong, your concepts are wrong, everything is an invention, a false invention against the truth. It doesn't make you reach the goal. It will make you try and evolve. Evolve towards what? Even as you are evaluating you know that all your punches have been devalued. Valueless. All your life, you know your concepts and theories and hypotheses and postulations are evil. Why do you follow that? About tomorrow, if you are a believer in God, it's not in your hands, then why do you follow step about only the tomorrow's life? It is as if it's in your hands. You are not God. When you think about tomorrow, you are a God. There's no God for you. As long as I am thinking about how I am going to live my life, when I am planning to live, I am plotting against myself. When you think about tomorrow and start planning, you are God. So the punishment does come to you. Don't think about tomorrow. Be grateful to what God has given to you today. And your worry and fear will be removed. Now you know you are in God's hands. As long as there is a worry, you have not given your thought to godliness, you have not valued God, and you have forgotten God. You remember you more than God, and so taste the punishment of Atma. And this is going to be physically affecting very soon on you. So, fear Allah when you have the fear about tomorrow. Fear Allah when you worry about your tomorrow. And when you don't know anything, still you say, I don't know anything, but still you believe in yourself. That is arrogance to the core. Is it easy now? I am believing in the last day means the day when it is going to occur. I have a worry about tomorrow, it is going to occur. That's the last day, right? I believe in God. Now that should be erased, or that should be still there, that worrying situation should be removed, or should be still there. If that worrying situation is removed, if it is accepted, it is removed, then and there it is gone today. Your planning and construction is demolished today. The blueprint is erased today, and his direction is now going to happen to take you. He is going to conduct you in his direction that will provide you paradises on this earth. You will live in paradise in the heart only. You cannot have your paradisical life here in the world, material world. That paradisical life for material nature is not given to you as a promise, but of the mind. The mind will create a situation, an environment more suitable to you, presently suitable to you. That is the paradise. You cannot imagine it. So don't see a physical palace. There is no physical palace. You have the physical dwellings here. That's all. The palace is different. Enjoy your life without the touch of physical nature. That is everlasting and ever-growing. Progressively without any end. No regression, no regression. It's a process towards progression. Believe in it. Believe in the last day. My belief in the last day is fear and worry about whatever I am thinking. This is what is going to happen. That's my end. Last. God has promised you, don't worry. That will be the end. So instantly it will be changed. When I am beginning to worry about tomorrow, okay, you are worrying about the shortcomings of your own knowledge, right? But soon you become forgetful of it and you are given a relief and there is a peace of mind. Where from it came? God erases it, but you stubbornly come to the same path again and you start worrying. A believer will not be behaving in such a way. Because I believed that my fear and worry should not be there, the way I am contemplating things should not be getting processed in this form. And God says, do not worry, I have accepted it. That's the reason generally he removes it and then relieve it for a while. Then I come back to my own godliness, my own as in the steps of God. Then I think, yes, all these things will be in a bad form for me. I am not going to get relieved of the imaginary life I have set for my future. I am not having any authority over my future. If you understand this, that is sufficient, godliness will work for you. First, you will be imbibed with, you will be infused with, inspired with godliness. And there will be intuition what you should do. Then your hands and legs and mouth will move. Now God is conducting you. When you are a God, you are also moving in the same manner, but things are in the way not you wanted them to be, but contrarily it is productive. So don't conduct yourself in counterproductive way, but in the productive way. What is the problem for us that we don't think about tomorrow? But all people will be saying, think about tomorrow, think about tomorrow. Do something about tomorrow. Then bring tomorrow here and do everything. We have a laboratory for you that I am actually creating an atmosphere. That is scientific. When you postulate something, you must prove it then and there. Until such time you prove it, your concept is not accepted. Yes? If you are thinking about tomorrow, planning tomorrow, bring the tomorrow here and do it. Why do you wait for tomorrow? That science is absolute absurdity. The scientific approach is madness. And postulating a concept and wasting all your life till your death. You are suffering hell here and you will suffer hell later. Those who have invented anything that you find is a material pleasure, definitely material pleasure doesn't suit your heart. My heart's contentment, my heart's composure, my heart's stability will make me live presently in any situation that is literally present before me. In whatever environment I am placed in, if my heart is okay, everything is okay, right? However beautiful the climate is, if my heart is not okay, everything is not wanted by me. I want to kill in that environment myself. Very simple to understand whether I will have the God's pleasure or not. Think about all. Painful heart is there now. And God gives you relief. Take that relief because He made you forget about your future. He made you forget about your own knowledge. That's the reason why you become peaceful at that particular moment. And whatever you eat on that day, while you have peace in heart, that is nourishing you. Whatever you consume for your life, when your heart is deeply troubled, that gives you, that food gives you evil energy. So while consuming your food, be careful that you are at peace with Allah. So what are you consuming, only food or water also? Even while drinking water, oh God, make good of your provisions to me. Is your provision. I am not just drinking water. When you are consuming food and water, air also. Even as you are living in your every breath, think about it more than thinking about yourself. So from the scratch, we have to correct and leave it with Him. You don't correct yourself. God correct me. Don't say I will correct you myself. It's impossible. Any good that you want, however small, however big, leave it with Him. So if any of you fear and worry about tomorrow, we are done. You are God after all. Don't follow the religious people belonging to religions. Be religious in your duty to Allah. The nun but him. Allah means the nun but him. The nun but him to surrender. Allahu, Al means the, La means no, who means him, the nun but him. Nothing, not even a simple thing in your heart, it is in your authority to command it. His is the command, not our hearts. So allow him to lead you, at least for 1 minute, then you will understand. He is allowing me to live alone for the whole day and whole life ahead of you to think about Allah. Now who is guiding you? Simply keeping quiet. You are being survived because of the air. You are breathing in the fresh air. Fresh air means the liveliness, the messages that I am receiving, I am believing. So what I am now breathing is a fresh air of life, not the air of painful death, not the air of the future, the air of His qualities, the air of His truth I am breathing in. I am being infused, inspired by His words, that air contains the words. I am breathing in the messages also, I am hearing the message also. Breathing in the message is more powerful than hearing from your ears. So the air conducts the voice, right? And the message is the air I am inhaling, the message is partly breathing, partly it is sounding in my eardrums. Don't follow what falls in the air, follow what is inspired. So believe in Allah that whatever I am hearing from this lecture, from the speech, you inspire me. What is true in the speech? I must hear to you. So do not listen to me while, but you listen to me while keeping in your mind that Allah must make you understand what I am. So even if I am not clear to you, God will make you take in the right sense, in the better sense. So above my speech, you must have the clarity that you have the receptive quality in the mind, because you believe in Allah. So in that way, I am not God, God is God. I have my limited ability to convey, but God has the unlimited capacity to make you understand. So what do we have now as questions? For want of clarity. Very good. To a great extent we have spoken the truth, so there cannot be any question. It is not the clarity you need from here, because you understand the truth that doesn't have the words to express. So the more you think now, the better will be the future. How do I know my future is better? No more worry I fear. The way you thought, but I fear only God. I must not slip away from His remembrance. Myself be not inclined towards the worldly things. So in that way I feel that my mind not be wandering away from the words of God that I am hearing all the time. Every time I am breathing in, I am breathing in His message. In the air is His message. And I am inspired, infused. The feel, the air does the feel. The air of contentment. Not the air of contentment, full of fury, awesome situation around me, the situation of doom and destruction around me. I don't want that contentment. Is it what you want? Okay. Very nice.